We were in Alabama, just outside of Gadsden, searching for the newly federally listed fish, the Trispot Darter, which is this really colorful little darter that gets blue and orange on it. This fish was listed because it's only found in a few places in Alabama, Georgia, and just barely gets into a little bit of Tennessee. In February, it swims up into forests or pastures that are dry most of the year, and the only time they're wet is in winter, and that's where it spawns and lays its eggs. The eggs hatch, the little larval fish hang out for a while, and then they eventually work their way back to the stream before those forests or pastures dry up. Now, when we think of fishes migrating to spawn, we think of things like eels and salmon, but you don't think of little things like darters. And I just find it fascinating that we've got little salmon, you know, making migratory routes out of a stream and into what is typically dry land and spawning and then returning back to the stream. I think that's really cool. After we sampled the one known breeding site for trispot darters, we went elsewhere on the property looking for new sites where they may be spawning. And that required us to go through a lot of briars and brush and some creeks that got about waist deep rather than knee deep, just to look to see if we could find some new breeding sites. We didn't find any, but it was an adventure bushwhacking through some of these backwoods.
Cute little trispot, he's adorable.
It was a little unfortunate, we only got one trispot darter, but it still wasn't a waste of time. We know that they're still there, at least in low numbers, using the site. But it's really never a waste of time going out and looking for fishes, because even if you don't find them, that negative information can inform you on when is the best time for breeding individuals. It's all good information. The next step is really to try to conserve those breeding sites that are dry most of the year, and then continue during this spawning season to look for more spawning sites for these individuals. The more places we know where they spawn, we can try to implement conservation programs to protect those spawning sites.